guys, welcome to my channel, or welcome back if it is not your first time. Today I'm going to be answering a couple questions that I frequently get on my videos, a lot of comments that are kind of the same. I figured it would be a lot easier to just answer some questions in a video so multiple people can get the response. If you all are new to my channel, my name is Ima. I studied food science in college and I got my bachelor's degree in food science. So currently I work for a global food company and my career journey has definitely been a little bit non-traditional. If you all have watched some of my other vlogs where I was teaching food science and I was in college, and there's just so many different areas of my life that have really landed me here, and I feel like I have just learned a lot, and this subject is becoming a lot more popular than I would have expected. So I'm really excited to just share some knowledge, share some of my advice. Definitely make sure to subscribe and check out some of my latest videos, my lives, weekly vlogs, and I'm really excited to just vlog a little bit more and share a little bit more of my life. So I have the questions here on my laptop, and if you guys want to be a part of this video in the future, definitely make sure to leave comments on my YouTube videos. I see all comments. I don't have a chance to answer all of the comments, so these videos will definitely help answer the questions. Hopefully your question can be in a future video. So the first question is, what do you do? And I get this question a lot just because I know the videos have kind of showed a little bit of what I do, but like I said, I work for a global food company and I actually work in regulatory. So I work with like raw material regulations, and currently I am wrapping up a project for the Asia region, which is just a huge milestone because it has had a lot of hills and valleys. But I get to study 10 different countries and go through different regulatory documents, make sure that our database is up to date with different limits and different regulations that the countries allow per ingredient. So then when product development scientists want to make a product and put a product on the shelf, they have to come to the regulatory department and ask, like, can we put this amount in our candy, in our chocolate, ice cream pop, you know? So yeah, that's just in a nutshell what I do. I also get to do some like digital communications, and that's been really, really fun just because I like YouTube and video editing and things like that. So another thing with that question is, a lot of people ask questions that I can't really fully answer all the time just because food companies are very, very private. There are certain things that I personally can't share with the public. I can't even share it with my family. So yeah, that, if you guys see some of my vlogs, you'll see like I don't usually show my computer screen or different applications that we use with the company because I can't leak that out to the public. So yeah, if you guys do watch my vlogs and you're ever wondering if I'm gonna show something like that, the answer is no. So yes. The next question is, what is your favorite thing about your career? And personally, I just like how unique the career path is. It is something that shocks people all the time when I say, yeah, food science, food scientist. They're like, I've never heard anybody talk about that subject. So yeah, I like how unique it is. And sometimes I feel like a secret food agent. I don't know what it is, but it's honestly mind-blowing how much work goes on behind the scenes of your favorite products. Like, just think about Skittles and Starburst or Lifesavers and Snickers, all these wonderful products, or you know, even products that I haven't mentioned. Just think of those products and think about, there are so many people that have to put work into that product before it even gets released and before you can even buy it at Target, buy it at Walmart. So I think that's probably my favorite part. Like, it's so low key, but it makes such a huge impact. So it's exciting as well. I think just knowing how there's never going to be like a dull moment and things are always evolving, and you know, there's always new products and new things to invent. I think that is also one of my favorite things. So, and you learn a lot. So it's like a forever learning situation. The next question is, where do you work? What company do you work for? Which company do you work for? And I get this question a ton. I was kind of torn between like answering this question and not answering it. I have always not answered questions like this, kind of private questions, just because of privacy reasons. Safety reasons, privacy reasons, I will not share the company that I work for, but if you guys happen to find out, if you guys find me on LinkedIn, because I know some of you all have, then it is what it is. But I feel like I do share a decent amount of information to kind of allude to what company I work for. If you do your research, then you will find out. But yes, please stop asking, please stop asking, please stop asking, because I will not share that as of now. Maybe in the future I will say, hey, yeah, I work for this company, but as of now, I'm just like, I want to keep it private. The next question is, what mistakes did you make early in your career? And I thought this question was really, really good because nobody's career is perfect. All of us have learned. Everyone is just a product of their experiences. And so I would say early in my career, when I had graduated college, for some weird reason, I had this entitled mindset. I thought that since I have a degree, all these companies want me. Like, when I step into the door, they want me. And I don't know why I thought that way. I really don't know why I thought that way, but that is definitely a mistake that I made earlier on in my career, because people don't owe you anything. So what, you have a degree. So what, you have an education. So what, like, you still have to work. You still have to, like, not prove yourself, but you still have to show that you are capable of doing said job. And that's something that I definitely would encourage people in college or studying the subject. Don't think that the work stops after you study. Like, you still need to put in that effort and like network and get to know people and learn and apply what you have learned, because yeah, you don't want to have that toxic mindset just like I was. I remember I had interviewed for this company in downtown Chicago, actually, and this was before I graduated, so it was for an internship, I think my sophomore or junior year, and I didn't end up getting it, and I was so devastated because I was like, I'm studying food science, I'm going to the University of Illinois, like, why don't they want me? And there's really something special about being humble and being just very level-headed. Like, you are going to be competing against so many people who are talented. They are so talented. That doesn't take away from your talent and your abilities and your knowledge, but you have to still be able to perform and be able to contribute and bring something to the table. Yeah, that is definitely a mistake I made, and I'm just really like proud of how far I've come even from that mindset, because nothing in life is handed to you, and I didn't even grow up that way. So like I said, don't know where that mindset came from, but I'm glad I don't have that entitled mindset in my career, because who wants to work with someone like that? Like, we want to work with someone who's hardworking, someone who is willing to do the work and not just like show up, you know? So I've learned a lot. I could do a whole video about lessons I've learned in my career. So comment down below and let me know if y'all would want to see a video like that. The next question is kind of on that same topic. Can you talk about job interviews and things you've learned or any interview regrets? And I love this question because I have gone on countless interviews. I have, prepared for so many interviews. I can't even count them anymore. But interviews are such a great way for you to study the company and think about all of your experiences and how they tie into that role that you're pursuing. So if you want to be a food safety scientist, you get to look at your experiences and say, okay, how do all of my experiences or my education show that I am qualified to take on this role. And I am going to be doing a whole separate video about how to apply for jobs, how I've applied for jobs, and how to successfully land the role that you're applying for. But something that I've learned about interviews is you have to go in with a strategy. You have to go in with a strategy. What in the world? You absolutely have to go in with a strategy and several scenarios that you can pull from that answer behavioral questions, technical questions, an interview regret that I have. I remember I interviewed for this food company a couple years ago, and I made it to like 3 or 4 rounds of the interview, and at that point I was like, this job is mine, like I got this job. And I think it was the 3rd or 4th interview. I had gone in person to interview. Yeah, I think it was the 4th round. And the interview went very, very well. At least I thought the interview went well. And it went so well that I forgot to send a thank you email. I did not send a thank you email. I don't know if I just thought that, like, okay, at this point, like, it's either they want me or they don't. But yeah, I did not send a thank you email. And when I tell you, I did not hear from them. And I remember like a month or two later, I tried to check in and it was crickets. Like, it was crickets. They did end up telling me that I didn't get the role. But biggest tip is to always send a thank you letter, always send a thank you email. It goes a lot further than you think. It goes much further than you think. And it's kind of back to that mindset about being humble and being like level-headed. No one owes you a thing, and it's so important to show your appreciation for people's time and for them to even think that you would be a good fit. I think is such a, it's like such a privilege, or such like a, I don't want to say an honor, but like, yeah, just keep that in mind. Like, no one owes you anything, and always show your gratitude by giving thanks and thank people. That is my number one piece of advice. Always be grateful, always be thankful, because people will give you their time and they don't owe you that. So even now, like in my career, it makes a huge difference when people say thank you. You know, if they've asked me for something, or even when I was a teacher, there were some students that you could tell were very appreciative, and then there were some students that were not. And it goes a long way. That entitlement attitude, it does not open doors for you, or it doesn't open the right doors. So the next question is, how is the salary? How much are you paid? Is the pay good? I get these questions a lot as well. And I know that on the internet, pay transparency is something that is super valuable and very important. I will not say exactly how much I make now, but I will say that since graduating, I have been paid between $50,000 and over $80,000 a year, which I feel like is awesome. It's super exciting to know that my hard work in college has landed me a lifestyle or a future like that. And in some of my past videos, I talked a lot about how stable food science is, or how like much job security is in this field. And yeah, I think that is also one of my favorite parts about the career. It has so much security and so much hope for the future in food, so it's exciting. Pay will also really depend on your experience, your education, and the company you're working for. Some companies have more money, and some companies may not have as much money, so they don't pay as much. But that, I think I'll do a whole video talking about pay and negotiating salaries and how to go about talking about money, because money is a very important topic, okay? I'm not gonna come on here and say that it's not, because it's important. It is important. This question is, how have you changed as a young professional in the food industry since you began? So I like this question because it allowed me to just think and reflect, and just kind of going back to how I used to be, especially in college. I was still so new to the subject that I don't think I was applying everything that I had learned. I was just taking in all this knowledge, but then failing to actually apply it to make sure that I understood it. And so I think as a young professional, I'm still growing, okay? I am still growing, but I think I've changed a lot in my mindset and my maturity, obviously. I mean, that's a given, but my mind is a lot more clear about going after the things that I want. I think in college, I was just kind of like, I don't really know what I want to do. Like, I didn't really have a clear idea on what I wanted to do, which is totally okay to an extent. Now, I've grown so much more in like my approach to things, the way I execute what I want. And I think I've also changed over time by believing in what I bring to the table. Because I think in college, I was often very, it was so competitive. It kind of was a bit off-putting. And when I got into the career, I realized, I mean, life, it's not that life is a competition, but you have to be a little bit competitive. Like, you have to know what you bring to the table. Over time, I've definitely learned my unique worth and what I authentically bring to the table. And that's a piece of advice that I think I also want to leave you guys with. Don't forget to be authentically you. I know it can be very tempting to replicate, copy someone else, or to go after a dream because someone else has done it and to try to get that dream the same exact way that they did it. But there's enough room for everyone to be themselves. And I think that's something else that I've slowly over the years grown into, just authentically being me. And I just love where I've come and how far I've come. I was reflecting on it the other day, and it's just really a blessing to even be in this career path, to have this platform to even share and educate and inform you all about food science as a career and as a subject, because it is so fun. It has just been so exciting. And so I hope that this video was really helpful for you all. I have a ton more questions that I want to answer. So if you guys like this video, definitely give me a huge thumbs up and subscribe if you're new. Subscribe if you want to see some content, some vlogs. I'm actually going into the office tomorrow, so I'm excited because I'm gonna vlog. If you guys would like to check out some of my latest videos, definitely check them out down below. They will be linked. I'm excited for some upcoming opportunities that I will be sharing in some future videos to connect with you all and to share more information just about my career journey, some stories that I haven't shared on YouTube. So please stay tuned for that. Follow me on Instagram if you guys do not want to miss out on that. So leave a comment down below and let me know, do you have any job interview mistakes? Do you guys have any stories? Comment down below and also put some questions in the comment section so I can pick them for my next video. Bye, guys.